डॉक्टर बाबा साहेब आंबेडकर ओपन यूनिवर्सिटी।
हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वार्म वेलकम टू यू इन चैतन्य स्टूडियो ऑफ डॉक्टर बाबा साहेब आंबेडकर ओपन यूनिवर्सिटी। आई प्रोफेसर अमित सुथार फ्रॉम गणपत यूनिवर्सिटी वुड लाइक टू इंटरेक्ट द सेशन इन रिगार्डिंग विथ वेब अटैक। बेसिकली द वेब अटैक हैज सेवरल सेक्शन लाइक ब्राउजर अटैक, वेब अटैक टारगेटिंग यूजर्स, ऑब्टेनिंग यूजर्स और वेबसाइट डेटा, ईमेल अटैक्स आर अंडर द कैटेगरी ऑफ वेब अटैक। सो थ्रू दिस सेशन स्टूडेंट शुड बी एबल टू स्टडी वेरियस काइंड्स ऑफ वेब अटैक, आइडेंटिफाई ब्राउजर अटैक, फिशिंग एंड गेट द डिटेल्स ऑफ यूजर फ्रॉम वेबसाइट। बेसिकली दिस ब्लॉक इज फोकस्ड टू सिक्योर वेब एप्लीकेशन हैज़ बिकम इनक्रेडिबली इम्पॉर्टेंट एज द इंफॉर्मेशन प्रोसेस्ड बाय वेब एप्लीकेशन हैज़ बिकम क्रिटिकल टू कॉरपोरेशन, कस्टमर्स, ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड कंट्रीज। वेब एप्लीकेशन मैनेज अ वाइड रेंज ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन इंक्लूडिंग फाइनेंशियल डेटा, मेडिकल रिकॉर्ड्स, SSN, इंटेलेक्चुअल प्रॉपर्टी एंड नेशनल सिक्योरिटी डेटा। द पर्पज ऑफ वेब बेस्ड अटैक इज सिग्निफिकेंटली डिफरेंट देन अदर अटैक्स। हाउ? इट इज इन मोस्ट ट्रेडिशनल पेन टेस्टिंग एक्सरसाइजेस अ नेटवर्क और होस्ट इज द टारगेट ऑफ अटैक, वेयर इज वेब बेस्ड अटैक फोकस ऑन एप्लीकेशन इटसेल्फ। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द वेब अटैक्स टारगेटिंग द यूजर। अमंग देम वी हैव डिस्कस्ड सेवरल फंक्शंस। नाउ क्लिक जैकिंग इफ द अटैकर रिक्वायर्स एक्स्ट्रा इंटरेक्शन फ्रॉम द यूजर टू लोड मालवेयर, दिस विल बी अकम्प्लिश थ्रू एन अटैक कॉल्ड क्लिक जैकिंग। द पर्पज ऑफ दिस अटैक इज टू ओपन द टारगेट वेबसाइट इन एन इनविजिबल फ्रेम एंड गेट द यूजर टू क्लिक समवेयर इन द फ्रेम when they don't even know they are clicking. That means user actually is not aware whether the click is legitimate or illegitimate. Means the hidden frame is there or invisible frame is there whenever the end user is going to click on particular button like submit, login or click me like button. At that time, user don't know whether the click is actually click on that particular button or performing some hidden malicious task. So, a common example is offering a bogus pop-up window. Sometime in website, you might get some pop-up window will be there while you are surfing the website. So such kind of pop-up is actually not dangerous, but while you are interact with that particular pop-up by clicking on that particular button, then after possibly you will be infected or system will be get compromised. So bogus pop-up window made to look up like a legitimate plugin update or antivirus alert, such as Microsoft Security Essential window that says you have a few virus and should push a button to clean them. Such kind of messages will be appeared or pop up while you are surfing some websites. So, normal user or end user will get click and get infected. The pop-up itself is not harmful actually, as I said earlier. But if you click the button, you open the gate to infect your machine. So that was the clickjacking example. Now onwards, web attack targeting users through plugin and script enabled attacks. Not only do attackers look for vulnerabilities within the browser itself, they also frequently ferret out bugs in browser plugins and scripting programming to help them carry out drive-by downloads and clickjacking attacks. In some cases, it may also make sense to turn off scripting within the browser and other susceptible programs such as Adobe Reader. Similarly, uninstalling certain problematic plugins can reduce the attack surface within susceptible user bases. So, what happened in plugin and script enable attack? You will have the advancement in browser itself, and you are installing some third party plugins. So through that plugins, if your plugin is not updated latest version, might be possible you are infected. Advanced phishing attacks. This is the next session in web attacks targeting users. Phishing is actually a one kind of a attack where the legitimate, it's actually a copy of legitimate website and user will goes into particular or visit that phishing website and provide some credential like facebook.com. So that is the legitimate website, but I said that facebook.com. So it is not a valid or legitimate site, but the human eyes cannot get easily the difference between first letter and end letter. And through that, we are always seeing that facebook.com, F and last character is K. In between, might be possible there are tricky way or FSE instead of FSE, you will get the FECA like this way. So, and it is look like the legitimate website, and through that the user will enter his or her credential, and after that they are providing this username and password also. And after the phishing attack, your account has been compromised. So while phishing attacks are typically associated with email, most are perpetrated via links to malicious content on the web. Whether a simple password capture form used in traditional phish attempts or a malicious drive by downloads in more advanced targeted attacks. So there are so many phishing attack in current digital era. Phishing attacks are designed to trick users into thinking they are a link from an organization or person they know, making people feel safe enough to click or divulge information they otherwise would not. If you are click on that particular link, you will be fascinated that it is a real or actual website, but it is not. And the user will get infected. Many corporate security training programs have helped users spot the most obvious first generation phishing attempts, which were designed to steal credentials such as banking password. And through that, attacker or malicious coder will get the credential. So that was the phishing actually. Nowadays, there are each and every human being going to post her or his activity on the social media platform like Facebook, Twitter, and LinkedIn, and so many social media are there. They are providing the gate for the easy access to the attacker by providing his or her personal details. So millions of people sharing information on social networking site, and it is an ideal attack bad for someone who wants to socially engineer a target individual, group of individual, or an organization as a whole. If people don't configure their privacy setting very stringently, attackers can simply troll their pages to dig up information about the target, and then on a particularly effective spear phishing email. Or attacker can pose as a friend or family to friend a target, or a friend of the target to gain that intelligence. Like, for example, I am the victim for this social engineering attack. Now, one of my friend is getting the request to pay a some amount in some critical situation. Actually, it is requested by the attacker from their own way on behalf of me, and my friend will get a message or some information regarding this attack, and he or she will perform or pay some amount to that particular friend of mine. But actually, it is not paid to me, it is paid to the attacker. On behalf of me, attacker or hacker is going to request for that request to get the money or get the help in terms of money. So through the social engineering, it can be possible. Then after, in web attack, there is a one category to obtaining user or website data. The value of web data, actually in today's digital era, the data is a crude actually, or we can say it's a black gold. So the value of web data is increasing in every industry, from retail competitive price monitoring to alternative data for investment research. Getting that data from a website is vital to the success of your business. For example, if you are visiting a store, then by observing your needs, you are going to purchase some breads for the breakfast. But at the same time, you will notice that there is a packet of butter is also there. So you are going to purchase the butter packet with bread, but actually you are going to purchase a bread packet. But somehow you are purchased the packet of butter also. So ultimately, in digital platform, we are going to visit some shopping, online shopping site, and through that you will also get suggested that that particular items is also you are going to purchase. So they are actually using your data of your interest. Based on your interest, they are suggesting. So how it can happen? There are web scrapper. Web scrappers automatically collect the information and data that is usually only accessible by visiting a website in a browser. By doing this autonomously, web scrapping script open up a world of possibility in data mining, data analysis, statistical analysis, and much more. So the web scrapper are basically creating such kind of script, and after, raw data will be collected from the browser or website's data, and after, they are machine learning engineer or data science engineer will perform some analysis and providing some suggestion for that particular need or interest of the end user. So why web scrapping is useful? We live in a day and age where information is more readily available than any other time. Web scrapping has emerged as useful method for gathering data programmatically from the internet. Web scrapping is the abstract term to define the act of extracting data from websites in order to save it locally. Think of a type of data, and you can probably collect it by scraping the web. Real estate listing, sports data, email addresses of business in your area, and even the lyrics from your favorite artist can all be sought out and saved by writing a small script. So these all data can be gathered by simply writing of a simple web scraping script. Then after, by inspecting web element, we are also getting some meaningful information. So modern web browsers allow us some details regarding this process. In Google Chrome on Windows, you can press Control Shift I, Control plus Shift plus I, or right click and select inspect. So through that, you will get such kind of screen like inspect element. And through that, you will notice that in screen, you will be able to see them some meaningful information for the web attacker or pen tester or malicious coder. They are getting such kind of information, but it is not basically available to the normal user, but it can be visible after performing this activity, that is right click on browser and click on inspect element. So that element have some meaningful information like function name or variable name, then some hidden links are there, so we can access through that element by inspecting such kind of element. The other type of response is like server can return data object as a response to a GET request instead of just HTML for the web page to the render. A website's API typically utilize this type of exchange. So many type of form is available for getting such kind of data like JSON, like XML. Okay, in this form we will get the data through the API. Then after, there is email attack. Basically it is recently the email attack is widely increased. So malicious email remains one of the most significant and ongoing computer security threats that we face. Cyber criminals use a variety of email-based attacks to deliver malware, lure victims to malicious website, and steal login credentials. So many people rely on the internet for many of their professional, social, and personal activities. But there are also people who attempt to damage our internet connected computers, violate our privacy, and render inoperable the internet services. So email is a universal service used by over a billion of people worldwide. As one of the most popular services, email has become a major vulnerability to users and organization. Through the email, we are getting some attachment which are not actually the legitimate, or it may contain virus, or it may harmful for our systems. So by downloading or by clicking some illegitimate click or websites, you will get infected. So malicious email authors are clever and relentless, and they are constantly developing new or at least different way to deceive and attack us. Although the malicious payload found in email-based attack frequently change the vast majority of cybercriminal uses basic strategies like malicious attachment. What happens inside a malicious attachment? Sometime attacker or hacker will send an email with like a upgrade for Windows or upgrade software. Such kind of attachment has been attached in malicious email, and normal user or end user will going to download, and after that he or she will system has been infected. So emails often include dangerous attachment that install keyloggers, ransomware and other malware when opened by the victim. Links to malicious web pages. As I said earlier, there is a possibility of phishing attack. So by observing or by looking, it is look like a same or legitimate website, but when you are clicking or by providing some credential, then after you will get compromised. So contained in either an attachment or in the body of the email, links to dangerous web pages also account for a significant number of data breaches. So below are some the most common types of attack. The phishing, as we have discussed earlier, phishing is a form of fraud. Cyber criminals use email, instant messaging or other social media to try to gather information such as login credential by masquerading as a reputable person. Whaling is a phishing attack actually that target high profile targets within an organization such as senior executives. Additional target include politicians or celebrities. So this is actually a phishing attack, but the name is whaling. Then after farming is the impersonation of an authorized website, is an effort to deceive users into entering their credentials. Farming misdirects users to a fake website that appears to be official. Victims then enter their personal information thinking that they connected to a legitimate site, but actually they are not. So such kind of attack is known as farming. Then after adware. So adware typically displays annoying pop-up to generate revenue for its author. The malware may analyze user interest by tracking the websites visited. It can then send pop-up advertising relevant to those sites. Some version of software automatically install adware. So actually they are doing their business by providing the unwanted pop-up. Then there is a spam. Spam is also known as junk mail, is unsolicited email. In most cases, spam is a method of advertising actually. However, spam can send harmful links, malware, or deceptive content. The end goal is to obtain sensitive information such as SSN, social security number, or bank account information. So these are the various email attack we have discussed. Now I would like to conclude over here. Thank you dear all. Smart Gaya.